Township for your verses 1 through 2. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you alone have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and blameless when you pass judgment. Indeed, I was born guilty, a sinner, and my mother conceived me. You desire truth in the inward being, therefore teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be white as snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Faithful and clean heart of God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore me in the joy of your salvation, and sustain me in the Holy Spirit. Word of the Lord.
What's the word? Oh, that's right. Very good. Good job. Covenant. Are you ready to do it? I point to you, right? Then what do you say? That's right. So I'll point to you, and then you say covenant, right? So let's, should we practice? All right, ready? Here we go. All right, good. All right, here we go. The day is surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new. There we go. With the house of Israel and the house of Judah, it will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt. A covenant they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the... Oh, I didn't point to you, remember? But this is the covenant. So I didn't really think you would remember it, but covenant. That's the word that we get in our scripture today. So, and do any of you know what a covenant is? Do you know what a covenant is? Would you like to know what a covenant is? Who would like to know what a covenant is? All right, great. A covenant is just an agreement, right? A covenant is an agreement. And our covenant in the church starts right here. This right here. You see this thing? What is this called? The covenant. That's right. Well, yep, that's, you remember the word. Our covenant starts here with what happens here. Those of you who are on the radio, I'm standing right next to the baptismal font. So what happens here? Yes? Babies get born. We might say that they get reborn here. Because normally babies are already born, but they get reborn here with the water. God makes them children of God. So that's the covenant that God makes with us. God makes us God's children. So you're a child of God, I'm a child of God, all these people here are a child of God. You know, when I was, right before you came up here at the beginning of the service, we do something that we call a confession. That's another big word, isn't it? Confession. Can you say that word for me? Confession. And you know what a confession is? A confession is basically just something that we say that when we do something wrong, we say that we're sorry. Whenever you do something wrong, have you ever had to say, I'm sorry? Yeah, that's a good word. You'll always have to say, I'm sorry. So that's what we say to God. We say that I'm sorry to God. And when I was little, you know that we said that same confession. Every week we'd come to church and we would say that confession to God. We would say, I'm sorry, God, for the things that I've done wrong. And when I was little, I thought, well, maybe I would grow out of that every week we wouldn't have to say, I'm sorry to God. But we keep saying it. We even said it this morning. So we always have to say that we're sorry when we do things wrong, meaning that, that's just something that we do, right? We say that we're sorry. And when we say that we're sorry, we learn that God has this covenant with us, that God loves us. So we're imperfect. We're not perfect people. We'll always do things that aren't right. But God loves us like we're perfect. So we're imperfectly perfect. That's the covenant that we have with God. He loves us always and promises to forgive us always. So when we say, I'm sorry to God, the covenant is that God loves us and forgives us, all right? So what's the word again? Covenant, that's right. And it's a covenant of God's love for us, right? All right, covenant, 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 covenant. I hope you'll remember that. Now, when I see you this week, I'm going to ask you, remember the word that we learned in church? And you're going to say?
Covenant.
Covenant. All right. You can go back to your seats. Thanks for coming up. What's the word?
Covenant.
All right. Pardon me?
You didn't point to us.
No, I didn't. That's right. I didn't point to you. Very good. What's the word? Bible, certainly covenant is one of those themes, you know. And maybe a person could even say that there are like seven or eight themes that repeat themselves over and over in the Bible. Certainly covenant is one of those themes that show up over and over again, but forgiveness is definitely one of those themes that show up over and over again. Jesus often speaks about forgiveness, and he does so as strongly as anything that Jesus says. And forgiveness, of course, is at the center of the Lord's Prayer. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us, right? So forgiveness is central to our faith. This morning from the Psalm, we pray these words, "Create in me a clean heart, O God." And that's also a word about forgiveness. It's a prayer about forgiveness. "Create in me a clean heart." And we sing that on Sunday mornings, and we read it this morning, but we oftentimes sing it. So when Vicki was reading those words, I bet you were maybe singing that song, by heart. "Create in me a clean heart, O God." So this clean heart, this new heart, is the heart that has been moved and transformed into a heart of love. The clean heart, the new heart, is a heart that has been deeply imprinted with this covenant of God's love. That is forgiveness. So how do we move from where we often find ourselves, hurt and angry and maybe victimized or abused or alienated, to where we can say, well, I'm more than that. And God calls me into more than that. So how do we get our minds and our hearts from the thoughts of anger and hurt and revenge to sincere forgiveness? How does God create in us clean hearts? That is what Jesus wants from us, right? Clean hearts. And it's the words from the prophet Jeremiah, that covenant, "I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more." That's forgiveness that Jeremiah is reminding us that God gives us. So forgiveness is a gift that we have been given, but like every other gift from heaven, it is a gift that is meant to be shared with others. To take that grace we have experienced, and then to pass it along to others, to the weary, to the hard-hearted, to the down and out, to the young and the old, to anyone who needs it. That's a gift that we offer, and it's not easy. It's not easy to do, and we fail a lot, just like we fail at everything else that we practice. But God picks us up and keeps pouring that grace into our hearts every single day, so we continue to pray to God, "Create in me a clean heart," knowing that the clean heart really becomes the heart that is capable of being moved to compassion. I always liked Miss Dagan. Miss Dagan lived in the upstairs apartment in the house that I grew up in. And she taught elementary school. She was the fourth grade teacher. I was in first and second grade when I lived downstairs from Miss Dagan. And I remember her listening to country western music loudly. So loud that the speakers would shake our ceiling, and Mom and Dad would have a word to say about Miss Dagan. But I didn't mind. I learned the words to a lot of Tony and Orlando and Dawn songs, you know, like "Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree." I learned a lot of Charlie Pride songs like "Kiss an Angel Good Morning," and so I didn't mind having the ceiling shake and hearing Miss Dagan's music. She probably had something to say about the noise that our family created too, all seven of us in our apartment. But I do remember Miss Dagan, and I remember many things about her. And what I remember the most was that she saw promise in me. like so many teachers are able to do. Not necessarily just to see the product in front of them, but to see what that person in front of them might be or might become. Great teachers see promise in others. And Miss Dagan was a great teacher. She always would stop what she was doing, and when I would wander up to her apartment with her colored beads hanging down through the doorways and her piece together carpeting from the samples that she had picked up from various carpet stores, I remember she would always stop what she was doing and paid attention to me. And I remember that it was this day that gave me one of my very first jobs, a paid job, that is. It was to take care of her little dog while she was away for the long Easter weekend visiting her family. She asked me to feed her poodle, to let it out on the rope and make sure that it had enough water and to pay some attention to it. And I was going to get $5 over the weekend that she had promised. So we were already dressed up for church on Good Friday, and I almost forgot to take care of Miss Dagan's poodle. So I went right upstairs to the apartment, already dressed up for church, and I scooped up the dog in my arms, and I carried her downstairs and outside, and I found her chain, and I sat the dog down to pick up the chain to attach it to her collar, and when I turned around, the dog was gone. I set the dog down and took my eyes off the dog, and there it ran away. The dog never ran away when Miss David took the dog outside. I never once saw the dog run away from her. But of course, then I realized that's why Miss Dagan never let go of her dog until the chain was already firmly secured to her dog's collar. Well, I realized that I had better start running after her dog because I wanted that $5, right? I wanted that money. Panic really started to settle in as I saw the dog run past the neighbor's garage, and the chase was on. I, in my Good Friday church clothes, my powder blue leisure suit with my white silk shirt with big blue flowers on it. Remember those shirts? With my wood choker chain on and my church shoes. So I started to chase this runaway fugitive dog through the back alleys of town and down the streets. And I wanted to capture that little darling. And I carried her home and as I walked up to the sidewalk near my home, I could hear my parents calling, "It's time to go to church. You know, where have you been? You've been gone close to an hour." Seemed more like several days to me, but evidently I was only gone an hour. But I had found this dog and saved her from the ravages of homelessness and starvation. I had saved her from fending for herself against the wolves and the deer, the squirrels and the raccoons, I suppose, and I saved my $5, more importantly. But I thought my family would be a little more excited and proud that I had risked my own life and the possibility of becoming lost myself in my effort to hunt down and save this runaway dog. But as I approached closer to my mom and dad, their mouth simply just hung open, because they saw me walking up the sidewalk, and in my blue leisure suit, I was covered from head to foot in mud and muck. My clean new leisure suit was covered, and I had never noticed. I had never paid attention to the mud puddles and the dirt that I had dived into to capture this dog for which I was responsible. I never noticed how dirty I had gotten until my parents pointed it out to me. And they did very matter-of-factly point it out to me. I was a mess. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. This little excursion of mine is what we do every day in the faith. This clean heart that we pray for this morning and every Sunday morning is ironically a very messy thing. Because forgiveness is a messy thing. It is a messy thing, but we are freed into it in so many ways. We are freed into forgiveness. And so oftentimes we don't even realize how messy forgiveness can be. And we play out stories of forgiveness every day in large and in small ways. In our private lives and in our public debates, we also play out not forgiving. In battles fought and in political grudges held and in family squabbles that continue over generations. And you know about this. We play out these stories of forgiveness or of not forgiving. But these stories of forgiveness, these amazing stories of forgiveness, when they are played out, we realize that we are free into forgiveness. Because the clean heart is the heart that gets dirty, a heart that is willing to take some chances. The clean heart is a heart that is willing to forgive. When we pray for a clean heart, we are not praying to keep that heart clean from service or clean from responsibility and the hard work that forgiveness entails. Forgiveness can be so messy, but it is one of the essentials of faith. And so God sent His Son to heal our broken lives, to cover our sins, to love us forever, and to forgive us and to give us a future with hope. But you know that it's never just about us. Because God is sending us on a mission of forgiveness as well. Setting us free to be agents of forgiveness in this world. So it's all about forgiveness. And forgiveness for us is one of the essentials of our faith. Think about it. It's really what our faith is all about, isn't it? To be freed in forgiveness. Every week we ask God to forgive us for the things that we've done and the things that we've left undone. Every week we also pray together the Lord's Prayer. And it's kind of a scary petition if you think about it. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Every week we hear that God fully forgives us all our sins and sends us out. Sends us out in the name of God's Son and in the power of His love to chase the things that are lost. To chase the things that are lost and to restore them. And to bring them back home. That's really what forgiveness is all about.